Don't catch you slipping, though. Don't catch you slipping, though. I don't know what that intro was. I am so sorry. Well, this is a YouTube video that I really believe is incredibly long overdue for me. Because backstory. I am an English teacher living in South Korea. And before I made the decision, I relied heavily on other YouTubers, other YouTube videos, talking about what life was like as a teacher, as a foreigner, cultural differences, race, all sorts of things. So I told myself, if I make it there, I'm going to vlog, I'm going to make these types of videos because it seems like a lot of fun to do. I've been in Korea for 14 months and I haven't done it yet. No excuse, I'm just shy, lazy, and a bit unmotivated. But I'm here now, so better late than never. So I thought I'd make a first video, I hope this won't be too long, to talk about how I came to Korea, how I got here, my process, and I have a little Ryan notebook with some notes here just so I don't wander too much off topic. So if I'm looking down, that's what I'm looking at. So I teach English with the TALK program, which stands for Teach and Learn in Korea. It's like a sister program to EPIC, English program in Korea, except we don't work full-time, which I like. We only teach at elementary school, which I love because they're cute little kitties. We only teach in rural areas, so no Daegu, no Busan, no Seoul. There's that. I don't mind being in a rural place, plus it's less crowded and cheaper. So there are a few different requirements. EPIC requires that you have a bachelor's degree, whereas TALK requires you to have at least 2 years worth of your bachelor's education finished. They accept an associate's degree, and you just have to be like currently enrolled in university, that sort of thing. On October 13th, 2016, that's when I first got word that this program was still recruiting. I'll never forget that day because it happens to be Jimin's birthday from BTS. I got word that they were recruiting again, finally. Back home to apply for my passport. I got it about a month later, and that's when I officially applied to the program. Now, to apply, you need to be from one of 7 countries, same as EPIC, I think. From Canada, the US, the UK, South Africa, Ireland, Australia, and New Zealand. I believe they only accept you if you're from those 7 countries. So after I applied, you have to send in 2 letters of recommendation, an official sealed copy of your transcripts, an apostille or apostille, I don't know how you want to say it, background check, a mock lesson plan, of course the application A and B, hard copy signed, a copy of your passport. What am I forgetting? Oh, sign the pledge, of course. So those are requirements. After all that happened, December 1st, I had my interview, the first one, because there's a physical interview at the nearest Korean embassy or Korean consulate, and then you have like a Skype interview if you pass the first one. So I went there December 1st. Some of the questions they asked were, you know, how are you with kids? Because with this program, it's only kids, only rural areas. So, you know, they're not as used to seeing foreigners, so that makes it a little more unique. So for a lot of these kids, you may be the first foreigner they see in person. I mean, these days, they love foreign movies and TV, so they've seen us, but maybe not so much in person. They ask you, how are you with kids? How are you in new situations? Are you open-minded? Are you helpful, friendly, patient? You have to be patient, my dude. My dude. You have to be patient to teach English to these kids. You know, nice, kind, basically everything you would want from your teacher to be. So, normal questions. And then they asked me, why Korea? And at the time, so it was a part lie, only partially. At the time, I was taking a class, Eastern Asian History. So we were only talking about China, Korea, and Japan. So a lot of this knowledge was fresh in my mind from studying for midterms and everything. So, you know, he's asking me, oh, why Korea? And I was like, oh, I love the history. I love the food. And, you know, Joseon Dynasty. It's amazing. And I had just watched this movie, Admiral Roy and Currents. That's the English name. With this general, Yi Sun Shin. It was amazing. And we talked about that. So that impressed him. And the guy interviewing me, he's, oh, that's amazing. Normally, people only want to go to Korea because of K-pop. I'm like,
K-pop?
What is that even? Like, K-pop? No. Which is a lie, because I do love K-pop. I like BTS, Dean, Monsta X, GOT7, Blackpink. I loved Sistar, and I'm so sad that they're gone. So yeah, like, I know K-pop, but I didn't want to bring that up to be like, K-pop, 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 because I didn't want him to see me that way. So that was the interview. It was pretty standard. Asked me normal questions. Yeah. 3 days later, I got word that you passed the first round. Congratulations. So that was December 1st. Everything was gathered and submitted, all the documents. So now I'm just waiting. I went home for winter break because I was in uni, university. And then I finally got another email about a Skype interview. Right after New Year's, and they scheduled it for January 3rd. So Skype interview, asked me a lot of the same questions. So that happened, and then I just waited and waited and waited. Now mind you, you have to arrive in Korea by February 4th. This is like January 8th, and I'm still just like, so what's gonna happen? Like, and mind you, again, I'm a uni student, university, so the semester was gonna start again soon. I'm like, should I register or not? Like, am I going to Korea or not? Where's my life going? So I finally, on January 10th, finally got word that I was accepted and I need to book my plane ASAP. Go to Daegu for a 2-week orientation so you can meet all the other teachers, all the new people. A great way to make friends, it really is, because everyone is in the same boat as you. Everyone's excited. A little nervous, you know, about being a teacher and if you're going to be good at it. So it's a really good experience in general. And then after the 2-week orientation, we got shipped out to our respective provinces and I was flown down to Jeju, where I lived for a year. Now, one thing that drew me to Talk over Epic is Talk is advertised more as an after-school program. But when you get here, you find out oftentimes they teach a curriculum too, which happened to me. I would have to wake up at like 6 every morning, catch the bus at like 7, meet my mentor teacher. They're the ones who are responsible for you at the school, so like if you have a problem, they're there. They exist. I would meet her at about 8:15 to 8:30 on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays to teach curriculum together. We taught together. Wednesdays, I only had after school. And for the first semester, Fridays, I only had one after school, and the second semester, I didn't work Fridays. It started 9 a.m. teaching, and then it would finish by like 4, but a lot of downtime in between. You teach for like 40-minute periods, and then you get like a 10-minute break, so like 9 to 9:40, 9:50 to 10:30, 10:40 to 11:20. I would have like a 2-hour break to just sit there and wait for my after school class to start because it didn't make sense to go all the way home just to come back. So I would just sit there at the computer just... I no longer live in Jeju because suddenly, Kapchagi, we found out, oh yeah, Talk is not going to be a thing in Jeju anymore. After they raved on about how it would grow because we're essentially the same as Epic teachers except we're cheaper because we get paid 1.5 million won a month. I actually make 1.6 million won. I don't know why, but I'm not gonna argue. Epic make 2.2 million. We work 15 hours a week. Only 15 hours a week. And I believe they work 22 hours a week. So the programs are super similar, except we get more freedom. As I said, Epic is like all of Korea, anywhere. Talk is only rural areas. Incheon is like a special province. You can only go there if you're of Korean descent and speak Korean. There's Chungnam, where I'm at now, Jeollanam, Jeollabuk, and Gangwon-do. These are the only places left. It was, Jeju was included up until like 5 months ago. Also, you get a 1 point, notes reminded me. You get a 1.3 million won, million dollar won. You get a 1.3 million won entrance allowance to like reimburse you for your flight, which was great for me because my flight was only like 600 and I got like double that. But depending on your province is when you get it. Sometimes you might get it like as soon as they meet you, sometimes not for like 5 or 6 months into your contract. Because sadly, it's been a thing where people just take their money and dip. They take their entrance allowance, the money they made so far, and then they go back to their country. That's terrible. You also get an exit allowance of 1.3 million won to cover your flight back home. And if you extend into the second year, then you get a one-time bonus of 1.5 million. So there's a lot of money in this. And I mean, you get to work with cute little kitties. Like, look at this. Teacher's Day is a holiday in Korea where kids, you know, they write notes and show their appreciation for their teacher. So like I said, I just started at this school because it ended in Jeju, and I've only been here since like March. At the time of this, it's May, but I got notes from my kitties. I know it's backwards, I'm sorry, but just know that they're super sweet. They write about how much they love English. I love you. I like English. I love you. Thank you. Like, it's these kids, man, they make it hard to leave. I will say that. I believe I covered everything on my notes. I do plan to make future videos about daily life outside of working here because, like I said, we work 15 hours a week, so we get a ton of free time. And there's also many random days off where classes are canceled, kids have swimming lessons, so you don't have to come. There's volleyball tournaments like today right now, so I'm off today. Found out yesterday, right? You get plenty of time to explore, not only this country, but neighboring places. I've been in Japan, China. I plan to go to Hong Kong because it's a city I've been wanting to visit ever since I played this video game called Sleeping Dogs. I've been dying to go to Hong Kong. I plan to go to Thailand. I plan maybe Singapore, Bali. Like, there are a lot of places to go here for travel, and flying here is a lot cheaper. It's a great opportunity, great experience. So yeah, I'm gonna make future videos about traveling, my daily life in Korea, weekends in Seoul, weekends in Busan. Now that I'm not in Jeju, I can travel more. So look forward to it. I'm gonna try to make these videos make sense, helpful, entertaining. I really, like I said, this was a major source of information for me. So I just wanna give back and try to. Thanks for watching if you did. I really hope I covered everything that I was meant to. My mind just wanders. If you like this, share with your friends, subscribe, like, the whole shebangabang, and I will see you guys soon. 안녕!